Welcome to Magic Duels, I'm your host Lostwolfe. We're doing the liliana best campaign that they set up for the game when it launched. And I don't think I'm going to teach anything today. It's just going to be a game of magic. We'll see. You return to the ruins of your family's manor. Before long, your skin begins to tingle. You are being watched. Dozens of eyes. Raven eyes. In a flurry of black feathers, a flock of birds merges into one shape. Into the shape of the man who tricked you into cursing your own brother. See, and, like, as she goes, she looks ever more evil. So, I'm sorry, but I can't really take her seriously. Oh, well. Okay, so we have a funny kind of land here. This is a land swamp. We're going to accept this hand. We're not going to ditch it. But this is a special kind of land. It enters the battlefield tapped, and each opponent loses one life. Activate this ability only if we control two or more black permanents. So there are riders attached to this, but that's okay. So now, because, and this is sort of not a teaching thing, but it's a common sense thing. Because this comes into play tapped, you want to play it as early as possible so that you don't have to worry about the tapped land in your future turn. So we're going to do this. Okay, yeah, sure. Hello, flying guy. Can I do this? Oh no, okay. I was gonna say if I could direct it at someone that would be useful, but eh. The other question is, do I do this? Oh, okay. Alright. Some cards say that you can only use them as a sorcery. This one doesn't, at sorcery speed. This one doesn't say that, so we can use it at any time. What are you doing? Oh, okay. It's a tapped carrion crow. He's the all flying deck, I think. Which is going to be a little bit tricky. Solus one. Number of zombies available. Okay. I guess we're going to attack. We can't block, so it makes sense to just, you know, go ahead and attack. I may in a little while, yeah, have to kill off one of the flying guys. Because there's no way for us to block them, and all they're doing is doing us damage. What are you doing, buddy? Oh, okay, it's just a horror. And it's a 4-2, sure. We will no longer be attacking. Haha! Okay. I think we do this because this lets me win. I inevitably have to block this. At least he's going to take damage. Yeah, I'm gonna have to kill off the flying guy. Flying, whatever, another creature dies, you may draw a card if you do. Okay, so this has got interesting wording. It says another creature. So if I should kill, I happen to kill this, the murder crows, it doesn't trigger. But he also draws and discards, which is kind of unhelpful for him, I guess. We're going to corrupt that. Oh, we're not, because we don't have the mana yet. what are we going to do here? I think we're going to make Soulless one. Bearing in mind that we're going to take 8 next. We need to absolutely draw a land. Maybe what I should do, actually, let's do this. How much is this? It's one of one of that. Oh. Nah, let's make a Soulless one. The reason why I'm making Soulless one as opposed to this is that while this does allow me to draw more cards, the Soulless one also, the Soulless one also has the neat, oh goodness, flying, one screeching buzzard dies, each opponent discards a card, okay. I think we're just dead here. Because I can kill one of them maybe if I get a land. Haha, no, I didn't get a land. Butcher Ghoul. Let's see if I can find... Well, even if I do find a land, it isn't going to help. Let's make you. And then I guess... We will reap. Very good. Uh-huh. Unhelpful. Yeah, we're gonna die. We will attack with our 6/6 because it gives us a little bit of... Oh! Why is he blocking? That makes no sense, but... Okay. I'll kill both of them. I understand I'm going to lose a card. Okay. The important thing about undying is that undying has to happen on the battlefield. In other words, if he dies, it has to be out in the open. If I pitch him into my graveyard like I could do here, it isn't going to help at all because he won't come back. But the problem is, between having this and this, I would much rather have this. So, let's pitch the Undying Man. Now notice he doesn't come back, because the wording mattered for when he had a battlefield accident. Yeah, okay, I'm gonna die. Sure. You make land, awesome. All that flying killed me. Haha! And this is what I mean, the black that they set up in this particular set is all about very slow control. And the result is that it was sometimes a little bit difficult to win. And I know that there was, at the time, frustration about the black part of this campaign. The other parts are fine, it's just this part wasn't so fun. We'll keep that. I like how we have corrupt again. Oh no, it's Altar's Reap. On the plus side, I have an outlet for him and I can make him stronger, but we'll do that in a minute. Okay, so in much the same way as this is a special land, this is also a special land. That's Drowned Catacomb, it enters the battlefield tapped unless you control an island or a swamp. He's only playing islands and swamps, so he gets to get that into play untapped. It's interesting that this counts as a swamp. They don't often do that on non-basic lands. Or at least they try and avoid it. let's attack and see how we go. Because even if he dies, it's okay. He's killing this guy and he's coming back with undying. Okay. Sure. Target player discards two cards. In response, we're going to alter sweep, so we have more cards. We're seeing more cards, and we can make a better decision about what we want to discard. But he now has to discard first. As a result of alter sweep. Oh, goodness. Okay, we're going to pitch land. Due to mind rot. And let's make a soulless one. Oh, I should have attacked there. That was a bit silly. Wasn't it just? Oh, interesting. Okay, so now we meet the criteria for this. We can actually do it. But I'm not gonna quite yet. Because we want to see as much of what we can about what he's going to do. And then we'll do that. Okay. Awesome. Okay, so it said each opponent loses one life, so if there's more than one opponent, say there were three other people playing against me, they would all lose one life. Activate this ability only if you control two or more black permanents. Anything that is not a land would count towards this. Land doesn't generally have a color, which is why we haven't been able to activate it. But we have permanents on the table. Permanents are any creatures or artifacts or anything like that. And so we've met that threshold. We have two permanents in this case our two creatures. They're both black. And so we can go ahead and do this. Unfortunately, it doesn't give us life, which is a thing I'd expect from a land like that, but it will. Okay, so now another quick interesting thing. We have five of these lands in play. But only one of these. I talked a little bit about the deck construction rules, but the thing about this whole situation is you can only have four of these lands ever. But you can have as many of these because they're basic and simple land that you need to draw power to make spells. And so you can have as many of them as you want. And again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We can win, yeah. Oh, that's much better. We're gonna make the land. I shouldn't be doing it now, but I say we can win, we might not. You might have a counter spell. So I think We're gonna be careful. Okay. I'm gonna discard bone splinters and land here. That's maybe not a good idea. But the corrupt is gonna potentially win me the game. Whereas the bone splinter isn't really gonna help much. And the land is just land. It's just gonna feed corrupt. There we go. And we won. Sometimes it is just a case of better luck next time. With your victory in hand, at hand, the Raven Man disappears as he arrived in a flurry of birds. They scatter in every direction, and you unleash every last bit of dark magic against them. The Raven Man survives, you are spent, and the power you wield begins to take a toll. So tomorrow we'll see the ending of this, and boy, that looks scary over there. But we'll talk about that tomorrow. Well, thank you so much for joining me today. As I say, I've been Lost Wolf. This has been Magic Duels Origin. The origin story of the five planeswalkers. We're exploring them very, very slowly. And sometimes I'm throwing in a little bit of knowledge about how the game works as we go. I hope that you're enjoying this as much as I'm enjoying playing it for you. I shall see you all soon. Have a wonderful evening. And good night for now.